Hi, and welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Ziv, and I'm here with Yotam from Nanit. Hi, Yotam. Thank you for joining.
Hi, Ziv. Thank you for having me.
Yotam, tell me about Nanit.
Nanit builds technologies to make parents' life more manageable. Our main product is the Nanit Pro Camera, a smart baby monitor that tracks baby sleep, wellness, and development.
Nice. So what are you going to talk today?
We're going to talk about our video ingestion pipeline and our streaming architecture.
Nice. So let's dive into the architecture.
Sure. So the first thing that happens is that our camera registering our system by communicating with our control plane. The control plane stores the camera state in one of our RDS clusters.
Right. So you have this state in the RDS where is the camera. And what happens next?
Now the camera starts recording short video segments. And once the segment is ready, the camera communicates with the control plane and asks for a S3 pre-signed URL and directly uploading it to one of our S3 buckets.
I get it. And you mentioned that you analyze this segment of videos. How do you do that?
So what we're doing is we're using S3 notification for when new objects are uploaded to the bucket. And this notification triggers a Lambda function. Mm-hmm. The Lambda function pushes the S3 key to SQS FIFO. And now we have our video analysis service that receives these messages and downloads the videos from the bucket and analyzes these videos. And we're using high performance GPUs to run our computer vision algorithms and to generate insights.
Nice. So you mentioned this EKS cluster that holds these services. What scale are we talking about here?
We're talking about hundreds of thousands of cameras that generate these videos for analysis.
Nice, it's a huge scale. And what kind of insights do you generate?
We generate what we call sleep insights. For example, when the baby wakes up or fell asleep. And we also generate sleep recommendations to help parents to train their babies for a better sleep. And we store all this information in another RDS cluster.
I get it. And I see a mobile application here on the board. I guess it's for the parents. How do they use it?
So the parents can use the mobile application to view all these insights and recommendations by also communicating with the control plane. They can also ask the control plane to play back the videos we used for the insights generation and using another S3 pre-signed URL to directly download the videos from S3.
So this is for playback. And what about live streaming directly from the camera?
So we do have live streaming capabilities. What we're doing is when the camera and the mobile application are connected to the same Wi-Fi network, the camera can push the streaming directly to the mobile application. And when the camera and the mobile application are not on the same Wi-Fi network, we relay the streaming through our servers.
I get it. So it's a complex task to stream through the cloud. Can you show us how you do it?
Yes, so what happens first is that the mobile application notifies the control plane that it wants to pull the stream. Now the control plane asks the camera to start pushing the stream. The camera queries Route 53 and gets a public node IP that runs in our EKS cluster. The camera now can push the stream through the node, and the node forwards the stream to our video streaming service.
Okay, and now the mobile application can stream back from the service. You are using client-side load balancing architecture here instead of using some kind of ELB. Why did you choose that?
We first used ELB for this architecture, but we wanted to find other alternatives to reduce our costs.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much for sharing this architecture, Yotam.
Thank you, Ziv, for having me.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.